Namaste and welcome. Om. Let's start the class by chanting Om. Sitting in a comfortable cross-legged posture, both palms in Chin Mudra. Rubbing your palms. Once we feel the warmth, we can cup the eyes. Keeping your palms in front of your face, a gentle blinking of your eyes.
Namaste.
So today we'll be practicing in yoga. Today's practice is basically related to the throat chakra, and so we'll start the class with simhasana first and then we'll move into the restorative postures. So you can either sit in a cross-legged posture, or if you want to enhance the effect, then you can come into vajrasana and spread your knees a little wide apart, keeping your fingertips facing towards the body. And we will look up and bring your tongue out, and then we'll roar like a lion 3 times. So you can open your eyes, look up, tongue out, and roaring for 3 times. Observe the sensation happening at the throat chakra. It really strengthens your vocal cords, stimulates your thyroid gland. If you can take ujjayi breath, you can take ujjayi breath. Making the sound at the throat region. So you're breathing through the nose, but your focus is on the throat region. Okay, so we'll just add some neck stretches right now. So there are three ways to do this stretch. Either you can just bring your right hand on your left temple and pull your ear away from the shoulder. If this is enough, you can just stay here. If you want some extension, then you can stretch your left arm by the side like this. Drop your shoulder down and bring your ear away from the shoulder. Don't stretch too much, but just try to be very mild and gentle. If you want to intensify a little bit more, then you can bring your left hand on the left shoulder and pull your shoulder away from the ear a little bit. We'll not hold here for 3 minutes. We'll just try and stay here as long as you're comfortable. Focus on your throat chakra. So that during the entire practice, even if you don't feel the stretch there in some postures, but try to bring your awareness there. Bring your chest forward, take your elbows back slightly. And slowly inhale and release the posture and go for the other side as you exhale. So even your hands can be stretched out like this. Focus on breathing, bring your chest forward. Constantly bringing your awareness to your throat region helps you to improve the blood supply, the oxygen supply at your throat region. And be very mindful and gentle and slowly release the posture. We'll do some more neck movement because we generally don't do another asana class. So you can bring your both hands on your forehead and press your hand backward and head forward. Just for 5 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Take your hands behind your head and now push your hands forward and head back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now bring your right hand on your right temple and push your hand towards the head and head towards the hand for 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Same change. Bring your left hand on your left temple and push for 1, 2, 3, 4. So in today's practice, we'll be doing Sarvangasana. We'll hold Sarvangasana, Halasana for a little longer today. So I would suggest you to have a bolster or one or two blocks will be helpful. So keep them handy. And we will start the practice now with the music. So we'll directly, there are two options here now. First, either you can just come into a double pigeon. If you feel that you're feeling a very uncomfortable sensation here, then you can use a block or a pillow below your knee. This will be really helpful. And then you can, your right leg is up, so you can bring your right arm under and left arm over into your eagle arms. And see what gives you more sensation. So there are two options. Either you lift your elbow up and bring your chin down, or you can bring your elbows down also and rest on your shin bone. So whatever seems more beneficial, more stretch for you, you can do that. Even if you want, you can keep the bolster here and you can exhale like that. Try to take gentle Ujjayin breath here. If you cannot bind your arms in eagle, then you can just keep it like this. This time, we'll continue to sit in this posture and bring your right elbow on the right foot and bring your both hands in prayer position and move up. If your neck starts hurting here, you can relax your neck. Always choose to keep a bolster or anything. If you are uncomfortable or having any uncomfortable sensation, just focusing on my breath. that's working, you can even look down, but just try to twist your spine. Back up. We'll directly move on to the other side. So this time either you want to keep your legs in double pigeon or you can even come into the gomukhi legs if you're comfortable. And from here you can take your left arm under, right arm over. We can start by bringing your elbows up and chin down. Whenever you feel tired, you can bring your arms down. In this posture, it is very easy to take ujjayi breath. In fact, you just have to bring your awareness. Ujjayi breath happens naturally. Your throat chakra is activated. Your words will never hurt others. Whatever you say will be out of love and compassion. Slowly inhale up and mindfully release the arms. Now you can bring your left heel on the right knee into a double pigeon, keeping a block here or even here, whatever makes you more comfortable in the posture and give you more stretch, you can do that, or you can do that. And bring your left elbow on the right foot, or wherever you reach right now, this one, and just twist your spine. Thank you. slowly, inhale and come back up. So now there are three options. First option is just to lift your legs up 90 degree while lying down. So you're lying down and just lifting your both legs up and staying here. Option two is to keep one or two blocks below the tailbone, lift up. Or the third option is to move directly into Sarvangasana. So if you feel that you will be able to hold Sarvangasana for 3 minutes, then you can feel free to lift up all the way and move into Sarvangasana. Make any adjustment that you wish to do by bending your knee and then once again come up. So we'll hold this for 3 minutes. Try to close your eyes and balance here. Focus on taking longer exhalation and shorter inhalation. So if your inhalation is 2 count, make your exhalation 3 counts. Whenever you feel tired, you can go back to the option 1 or 2 and stay there. Slowly bring your legs towards the head and keep your hands down as you break, and slowly come down. One vertebra at a time, feel each and every vertebra and then relax your legs. Just stay here for about 5 breaths. I can easily feel that the blood is once again flowing back towards the leg. Now for Matsyasana, there are 2 options once again. So
The first option is that you keep the block or the bolster behind your head, just to increase the height here so that you can keep the legs on the block, or you can also go closer to the wall and then just take support of the wall. So I'll just show. So let's say I'm doing halasana here. I'm touching my legs to the wall so that it doesn't give real pressure on my neck, because otherwise I have to drop the toes all the way down. It can give real pressure to your neck. So from here, you can keep this towards the wall, or you can also keep it on the block. The other option is that you take the bolster or the block and keep it behind your back. So when you lift your legs up and go back, you can place the block here so that you support your middle back and just stay here. Or as much as you are comfortable, you can push your blocks closer. Maybe your toe touches, maybe your knee touches the forehead, where you can bend your knee and bring your knee closer to the ear. Anything is fine, whatever makes you comfortable, just do that. So other option is that you can just keep the blocks below the hip or the tailbone and just stay here like this. So even this one is fine, because you are finally getting the stretch here in the throat region. For others, we can go into halasana. I would prefer to do with the blocks. So I'll keep the blocks here handy, and as I move into halasana, I'll keep the blocks just below my middle back. So it is actually supporting, and I'm taking my toes towards the head. So you're not forcing here. In yoga, we don't do any kind of force. You just try to stay here and see how your toes are moving towards the floor. Not necessary that you have to stay here for 3 minutes. Just try to stay as long as you are comfortable. If you want, you can take your arms above the head towards the toe. Slowly, you can remove the block, and one vertebra at a time, you can slowly come down. Now we'll have to do the counter portion, so we'll move into Matsyasana. This time we'll be doing the supported Matsyasana. So you can take block, choose the level you wish to keep. have the stretch in your neck. So if this is even this one, this is too much, maybe this is good enough. And you get them from the head like this. Even if you have a bolster, it's a very good option to have a bolster, much more comfortable than the block or the pillow. You can keep the pillow as well. And just drop your head down like this. But I don't feel much stretch here, so I can maybe add the block below the pillow. Yes. So now I get a very good stretch here. So we'll hold this posture for 3 minutes. You can also choose to have 2 blocks. If you want to have feel further, stretch. In this position, your ribcage is expanded to the maximum capacity. So, take this chance and try to breathe deeply through the chest. So the upper lungs can really expand to maximum capacity. Try to take longer inhalation and longer exhalation. Push your elbows down slowly. Inhale, lift your head up, chest up. Release the block and just lie down in Savasana for a few breath. Slowly, whenever you're ready, you can turn on to one side and sit up. You can already feel a very light, a lot of lightness in my upper body. So I'll slowly transit into child's pose. So you're sitting on your heel, If you are not able to sit on the heel, maybe you can keep a pillow here and just lean forward. And once again, focus on your throat region. Either bringing your forehead down or the crown of the head down. If you can bring your crown of the head down, then you can easily feel the stretch in your throat region. You can also do this posture this way, catching your heels and just lifting your tailbone up as high as possible, bringing your crown of the head down. And slowly inhale, come up and move into a downward facing dog. Chin to the chest and gaze at the navel just for a few seconds here and take deep and long chin breath. And now slowly bring your right leg forward directly in between the thumb. Drop your left knee down. You can keep two blocks by the side of your leg and come here. So focus on just pressing your hip down. Your right shin is perpendicular to the floor. If you want, you can push in your knee by your holding the mat. And we'll just stay here for 3 minutes. Just look up. Can be really intense now, but it's fine, just focus on the breath. This is a good time to realize that you are not the body. Just ensuring that it doesn't turn into pain. It is still a very deep stretch and sensation of the stretch alone.
your hip down as much as you can. Try to bring your left thigh towards the floor. Try to keep your back straight. Whenever you're ready, you can bring your left leg forward. Maybe using the block or without the block. Take deep and long Ujjayin breath. Ujjayin breath really makes the flow of air in the lungs almost double. So normally when you breathe through the nostril, you only take half of air as much as you take in Ujjayin breath. Focus on lifting your heart up. Slowly, slowly now we are getting into the deeper connective tissues. Flexing from there. And slowly once again moving into downward facing dog. From here we can just lie down on the belly into a sphinx posture. So once again you are lifting your chin up towards the ceiling. Feel the stretch in your throat region. If you wish to, then you can use the block and elevate your elbow up. breaths in for a few breaths. Make your way to your lying down on your back for the last two postures.
Lying down on the belly, spread your legs a little wider than the usual length, maybe you could go towards the edge of the mat, and now bring your both knees towards the left side and then take your left heel on the right knee and push your right knee towards the floor and look towards the right side. So when you bring your right ear, here this time you will not focus much on the legs, but you will focus on the neck. So you are twisting your upper, the cervical area, which is the neck area, and you are bringing your right ear on the mat. So you can feel the real stretch in your throat region. So once your ear touches the mat, or try to bring your cheek onto the mat, and then if you wish, you can press your knee, the right knee towards the floor with the help of your left ankle. So your left ankle is actually pressing your right heel down. mindful and gentle release. And directly move on to the other side. Drop your both knee onto the right side, right heel on the left knee, and bring your left ear on the floor. Slowly release and lie down in Savasana. Just for a minute. Observe the benefit of the today's practice. Interlock your hands above the head, give a good stretch and release. Turn to the right side and slowly sit up. Sitting in a comfortable posture, both hands in Chin Mudra, inhaling for Om.
Swasti prajabhyaha paripalayantam nyayena margena mahimaheshah gobrahmanebhyaha shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Shanti, shanti, shanti.
Rubbing the palms. Once you feel the warmth, we can cup the hands. Feeling the indirect warmth, keeping your palms in front of your face, gently making it. Thank you. I hope you're feeling good. Even I'm feeling good, totally refreshed today.
Thank you very much for joining me.